Since the beginning of time, mankind has been making music as a means of entertainment, enjoyment, salvation, and seeking a better understanding of life. Stringed instruments have been used for thousands of years all over the world and are still very popular today. So how exactly do these instruments make sound? And why are they all shaped so differently? Let's begin by reviewing what we know about sound. Sound is a comprehensive wave that travels through air, and a wave is any disturbance that moves through a medium. Sound is produced when something vibrates, and when the object vibrates, it vibrates the medium around it. This enables the sound to travel outward through the medium. So whenever we hear a sound with our ears, we now know a number of things. First, we know that a vibration must have occurred. Whether it's the vocal cords of a flying loon, or the wheels of a train on a track. We also know that these vibrations caused a disturbance known as a wave, and this wave traveled through the air to cause our ears to vibrate. A person's perception of sound waves is known as hearing. Now let's begin to talk about frequency. The frequency of a wave refers to how often the particles of the medium vibrate when a wave passes through the medium. For example, if a wave passed through a medium 10 times in 1 second, the frequency of the wave would be 10 times per second, also known as 10 Hertz. A sound wave with a high frequency has a high pitch, and a sound wave with a low frequency has a low pitch. The average hearing range that we as humans can hear is between 20 and 20,000 Hertz. This gives musicians quite a bit of room to work with. Pitch is not the only factor in defining the sound that we hear. There's also loudness, which is our perception of the amplitude of the sound wave. And there's also our perception of harmonic content and resonance, which is called timbre. Timbre is the most key factor when talking about musical instruments. It's what gives every instrument its own special, unique sound. For instance, it's the difference in timbre that makes an accordion sound different than a didgeridoo, or a flute sound different than a trumpet, and so on. Listen to the fiddle, the banjo, the guitar, and the bass, as they all play the exact same note. As you can tell, even though each instrument was playing the same note, each created its own unique sound. Every object has a natural frequency. A natural frequency is a frequency at which an object tends to vibrate when hit, plucked, strummed, or somehow disturbed. The natural frequencies of a musical instrument are often referred to as its harmonics. It's these harmonics that determine the timbre of the instrument's sound. Objects with only one or a few harmonics, such as a flute, are often described as having a more pure tone, while objects with many harmonics, such as a tuba, are described as having a richer tone. But let's get back to stringed instruments. The final term we need to understand is resonance. Resonance occurs when one object vibrating at the same natural frequency of a second object forces the second object into vibrational motion. So when a string is plucked on an instrument, it travels through the bridge and to the body of the instrument and vibrates the entire instrument at its natural frequency. And it's because the body of the instrument vibrates that more sound waves are created, thus amplifying the sound made by the string. Now that we've learned how string instruments make sound, let's take a look at how we can use mathematical equations to determine the frequency of the string. Since we know a lot about what can affect the pitch and frequency of a string, there is an equation that we can use to find the frequency for any string. First, we know that the longer the string is, the lower the pitch and the frequency will be. So if we shorten the string by putting our finger on the fretboard, then the frequency and the pitch will get higher. We also know that the greater the thickness of the string is, the lower the pitch and the frequency will be. And finally, we know that the greater the tension of the string is, the higher the frequency and the higher the pitch will be. With this information, scientists have found that frequency is equal to 1/2 of the length of the string multiplied by the square root of the tension over the linear density. And linear density is equal to the mass of the string divided by the length. This equation can be used to find the frequency of any string on any instrument. So remember, music that we hear from stringed instruments is produced when the string vibrates, and the string then vibrates the body of the instrument, which has a unique natural frequency, which contributes to the timbre of the sound that's made by the instrument. I see elephants that are calling pigs.
Right. This business.